G'day, Dad's Army, it's Two. This is my trip from Launceston to St. Helens. Quite a beautiful little track up through Lilydale. Check out the falls there, of course. The falls at Lilydale are quite spectacular, but I would say make sure you've got proper shoes on because the track was a bit slippery in spots. Quite a good trip. There's a lot of little towns on the way over to St. Helens.
This is the Lilydale Falls. Just
definitely
out of
worthwhile going across.
Beautiful. This is a lot
the way I'm about to show you, because you get to see a lot of Tasmania. And I will admit, I don't know if there was much other way of really going to St. Helens anyway. But check this video out, and hopefully it might better help you with something. If not, just some quite spectacular footage. Most days the temperatures were anything from 18 to, I think it got down in this area where we are now, probably maybe 15, 16 degrees. But on average it's around about 20, 22 degrees in Tassie around Christmas time. Quite a nice time. It's not as cold as you would think. It was, if we didn't have a breeze at Freycinet, we would have actually gone swimming, but it was a bit chilly that day, so it was the only time we were able to go for a swim. But Tasmania is not as cold as you think during summer. To get to these falls, Columbus Falls, average walk down some couple of steps. The rest of it's just sort of on a slight incline, very easy to get to. And there is, on the same road, there's actually a cheese factory, and you can actually go there for lunch. And this is probably 12 or 13 k's up past that. A bit skinny in places to get there, but quite a beautiful place. This is not far from St. Helens, up near the Bay of Fires. They call it the gardens only because of the stuff growing on the rocks gives it that texture. I actually found it more beautiful just the area that I was in, because those rocks are sort of virtually everywhere along most of the areas you'll actually see us taking on this trip around a bit of Tassie. It's actually a little private beach there for a house not far from there. I didn't take a photo of it, but lucky bastards. Still definitely worthwhile. That's at Bimbalong Bay. Beautiful cafe. Beautiful coffee, meals. If you wanted to, you could actually go there from St. Helens. It's maybe 15-minute drive. This is down not far from Bishano. And as you can recognize, there's the red stuff growing on the rocks, which looks a bit like the the gardens. And every time I saw anything look like that, I kept on telling my wife, yep, that's the gardens. She got sick of it after a while, because actually you find those rocks sort of along the area we are there quite often. Okay, next time you'll hear from me, it will be Fraser Nate. Catch you later.